see where we have the incumbent MP, Adjoa Safo, there going to cast her vote. And there's an interview currently ongoing. So let's take a listen.
In the midst of COVID, we want to ensure that we won't have escalated numbers after. So you can see everybody comes in, votes and goes away. And it's very good. I just finished voting myself. And I'm very confident that I'll be victorious.
But how's the process for you?
It's very expeditious, it's very simple. So I'm sure people will just come in, vote, and then go home. And that's what we want. Everybody should stay safe. And so, yeah.
You say you are very confident, but some other people think otherwise. They think that this time around, the Mike Okoye will give you a run of your money.
That's their opinion. I think that my good people remember me for the long time that I've been with them. So, in opposition, I was with them. We are in power, I'm with them. And so for me, four more for Nana will mean justifiably four more for myself as well to complete the good work that my government in 4 years is doing. And Nana will continue 8 years. And so I'll continue with him.
If you're projecting this and also comparing it to what happened in the previous election, do you think that you're going to have an overwhelming even vote more than what you did in the past?
I believe so. I believe that this will be unprecedented.
You think you wouldn't be surprised when that doesn't happen?
I know what I'm talking about, and I believe my people, and I believe in God. It is God that is the kingmaker, and I know that I'm declaring victory for myself in the name of Jesus, and I'm declaring glory unto myself in the name of Jesus.
But before the election started and of COVID-19 issue came in, there was some information circulating that people were saying that Mike Okoye has come out of the contest, and they suspected that was coming for your camp. And what do you have to say about that?
I would say that what we were told at the time probably is not what it is. And so as you can see, there's a contest, and I was ready for that contest. I've always gone for a contest, so this is no surprise to me.
So, madam, should you come up top today? What should a good
I will come up top.
But what should the good people of your constituency expect from you for the next 4 years?
What my slogan is for this election, which is that we get our victory in these primaries, we get development massively, a continuation of what I've started, which is the continuity and development and victory that I have as my slogan for this election.
Just briefly back to COVID-19, do you think we should expect this form of voting come the general election?
I strongly believe that this is the way to go. Okay. So that we won't have escalated numbers in the recorded cases of COVID-19. So
we know that times like this, there's always division, one party belonging to the other and all those sort of. After the election, what would be your strategy in making sure that unity prevails within the Dome Kwabena constituency?
It's bringing everybody on board, and I've done it before. I've had a first contest, I've had a second contest, and this is my third. And after I'm able, as a mother, as a woman, bring everybody on deck, on board, and we'll forge forward, because the elephant is bigger than all of us.
And you'll be able to do that, including your contender?
We've done it before, so we can do it. This is not the first time he's contesting, yeah.
Thank you. All the best.
Thank you so much. So that was the incumbent member of parliament for Dome Kwabena, who just came to the Taifa South to inspect whatever is going on. He has already cast...